the fields. Okay, and what are the operations you can do on accounts? So most of these operations are generic to other records as well. What I mean by that is creating new account, update an account, delete, bulk delete accounts, activate, deactivate accounts, assign and share accounts, merge two accounts into one, duplicate detection, add to marketing list. So one thing we need to tell about deleting now. So in Dynamics CRM, especially in the staging or production environment, we never ever supposed to delete your accounts, right? So what happens is when you delete an account, all the related contacts and other records will also be deleted. So not only accounts, any records in CRM system are not supposed to delete. Instead, you should make them deactivated, right? So that you can again access them. We'll see how we can do it. Okay. So first, see how we can create a contact. We can create a account. We can create an account in two ways. One is from the ribbon. Click on this button. So it will open up a new account form. So only two fields are mandatory. This field is already set to my name because I am the current login user. So I can mention the Citrix Limited as the company name. I can mention the phone number, fax, whatever all that I can mention. So these are the two fields only I want to set now. Then I can click here as save. I can click here. Once I click on save, this account will be saved. Right? So now we got the new name. Here you can see under this activity field, a new activity is created, a new post is came up, right? Account created by Firoz on Citrix. So this is nothing but a wall like Facebook wall, where post activities and note will be displayed. So what all the which all the users in the system have access to this account will be able to see whatever I am typing. I can also post something. I just created an account for Citrix, and if I post it, it will just comes like in a Facebook wall, which will be displayed to all the users who have access to this account. Then you can see activities that you have seen and notes also. You can add note also. Like if you want to upload one document here, you can add it as a note. This will be attached with this account. Okay, so like that you can create the account. The second way of creating account is using Quick Create. Right. Once you click on it, you can see the account here. So Quick Create option is available to account. Once you click on it, you can see a minimalistic form. It's not the entire form. This is minimalistic form, which minimal number of fields are coming up, where you can mention the details of Polaris systems. You can mention other details, address and all that. Click save. So the idea of Quick Create is nothing but create an account or any other record with less number of clicks. Instead of I'm going here clicking, I mean, now I am in account already. So if I am in some other record, then I need to go to sales, click on accounts, then go to this section. I mean, go to plus new, enter the detail and save. Right. Instead of that, from wherever you are on the command button, or click on Quick Create, select it, enter the value, save it. It's like two or three clicks, where it will take 4 or 5 clicks. That is known as Quick Create. So these are the two ways you can create an account from an editor delete accounts. Okay, so you can edit your existing account, provided that you have the security privilege for it. So you can edit single account records, also multiple. So how will you edit a single record? So this is an existing account, right? So if I want to any other field over here, So what I need to do is I need to open this record and update it. Then I can click save or save and close. Save mean it will just save it and it will stay on the form, and save and close mean it will save and close the form. So like this I can open up any record and update the fields, or else I can click this record and click on edit. That will again open up the form, okay. Then you can edit it, and there is one more option called multi-edit. I can select multiple account records. So all these options I am talking about now are common across all the records, accounts, contacts, marketing list and all that, right. So now I can click, if I click edit, so a new form will open up. This is nothing but multi-edit option. Now if I want to set for all these three records the account rating need to be given as default value, or category need to be standard user, address need to be the same address, so I can mention them, then click save. What will happen is the same value will be saved to all these three records I have selected. So you need to make a little, you need to do it a little careful also, because if I give the same account number here and click on change, what will happen is all the selected records will have the same account name. That will mess up your entire data. Okay, so this is a very useful way to update your records, multiple records same time. It may backfire you if you are not doing it properly. So that's about multi-edit and edit. Then you can delete your records by clicking delete. You can create single records as well or multiple. So what it is saying here is deleting accounts will delete all the records under the accounts, as well as social profiles, opportunities, activities and contacts, etc. So the sub accounts related to this also be removed. So deleting an account is a very costly thing. All the contacts, accounts, everything related to this account will be deleted and you cannot retrieve that back. So deletion is not at all an option for accounts and contacts anywhere. In the production environment, normally we don't give access first of all, but even in production, even in staging or testing environment also, we're not supposed to delete anything. Rather, you should deactivate them. We have an option called deactivate records. Deactivate means they won't appear here, because this is a set of active records. Once you deactivate, the account status will change to inactive mode. If I deactivate this record, so it won't be anymore coming up here, because the status changed to inactive. So then I go to inactive records, I can see that record, so I can activate it again. So this is the ideal way you need to do if you don't need an account anymore. You're not supposed to delete it, just deactivate it. So in future if you need it, you can reactivate it. Okay, so now let's have a look at how accounts are related to contacts. So an account can have multiple contacts associated with it, or can have zero contacts. So that is very clear. So what the example says, for an MNC, you are selling your product to, can have dozens of contacts you are in touch with, or an government organization where there won't be any contact to deal with. So account can have one or zero. Account can have any number of contact, or it can have zero contacts. Okay. So some of the related entities of a contact. So by default, account have relationship with all these entities, activities, contacts, connections, documents, audit history, opportunities, etc. In addition to this, you can make relationship with other entities. For example, if I want to make a relationship with the contract doesn't have a relation with account now, I can make that. So how will I identify or I access the related entities of a record is, I can go to this ribbon. So this is sales accounts, this is the present account open. Click on this button, I can see all the related entities. So if I go to the activities, I can see all the activities which are